So if you would introduce yourself.
Yes, hi, I'm Alexandra Singer. I have two beautiful boys, 16 and 13. I live with my mom, or my mom lives with us, and we have a beautiful dynamic now, but it was not always that way. I've been part of the parish for only 6 years, and I've been a part of so many different ministries. I have enjoyed so many talks. I've learned so much at this parish that I'm so grateful. And as I said earlier, I'm really happy to be able to share with everyone here that I meet at the church. But the title of have I felt that God has called me from something, and it's been so touching to do the God's Calling series, because I realize now that God answers our prayers, or has answered my prayers, not in the way I expected it. You know, for 19 years, I had a very difficult marriage. It was, there was a lot of arguing. My children grew up in a very hostile environment. They knew we weren't happy. And as all children, they wished their parents to get along. But 5 years ago, I became a single mom, and with two adolescents, so it became very challenging. Am I being a good parent? How am I going to do this alone? And I realized that God, our Lord Jesus, was going to be the father at home. He was going to be my partner. He was going to be my love, my guidance counselor, my teacher, my everything. And during the divorce period, I prayed that He would help me, that He would be my lawyer. And that was when I realized that Jesus has many titles. And I didn't want to fight over money. I wanted, I didn't want resentment between my ex-husband and I. And I prayed so much that God would touch the hearts of the lawyers and would help them be fair for both sides. And I couldn't have had a better lawyer. And I share that story with so many women that want to go to litigation, and they ask me, you know, I want to get divorced, and I say, I would never wish anyone to get divorced, first of all. But if that's what you've decided, do it in a very amicable way. And I truly believe in collaborative process, which the lawyers were very experienced, but just very humble, very fair. And I know God's hand was on this, because my ex-husband said, I don't know why they think you're so perfect, and why they fought for you, but my lawyers were fighting for you, and he was very angry. So I know that it was God's hand on this whole process. And that was the first time that I felt I could just release my fears, my frustrations, my anger, and just I felt such peace throughout that whole process. And since then, I've been giving God, or my Lord, I've been giving Him a title. He's my husband now. And I wear a ring that has a cross. And I say he's my friend. And I understand now when I remember of Scripture, when I'm not quoting this, but when St. Paul says that if you can be single or alone, it's even better. And I know I'm using my own words, but the way I interpret that is, if I could spend my life with God, I would be the happiest. And of course, it's beautiful to be married, to be with a family, but no one's going to fill that void. And I tell my children that. I tell my mom that. I said, Mom, no one can fill that void. It's only God's love that can really fill us. And so I love my boys. My relationship is getting stronger each day. It's a challenge. My teenagers are always challenging me, and I'm learning so much from everyone at the church. I ask for advice from everyone, and most of my friends now are grandparents, because I just enjoy their wisdom. And Sister Henrice, I'm sorry if I'm destroying her name, but she said, we're not called elderly anymore, we're called adults because of our wisdom. And I said, very true. And I really am enjoying my friendships. with that generation, because I realize that they're giving me the reassurance that I'm doing okay and that God is with me every step of the way. And no matter how difficult the storm, He's giving me the peace to go through it. So I felt a calling throughout this difficult time. I wasn't allowing myself to grieve. I did not want to become bitter. I did not want to become sad. So I was becoming very active at the church. And then I realized that there was something nagging and that I wanted to go to the nursing home at Allendale. When I went to Allendale, I was so happy to hear that they would allow volunteers. So I started off with just being a companion to any resident that didn't have family visiting. And I enjoyed talking to them. I enjoyed just laughing, hearing their stories, or just giving them keeping them company. And then not too long after, I realized that they didn't have many activities. And the nursing part side, there's where there's Medicare and Medicaid, there's really not much funding. So I decided that, you know, to ask, am I able to maybe do some stretches, some light stretches, like I have experience with yoga and with dancing. So I said, maybe they'll enjoy that. I tried it, and I've been doing that for maybe 2 or 3 years. And I love it so much because they just want the love. I spend a good 5-10 minutes just hugging them. They pull me to kiss me, and I've been reprimanded that be careful because, you know, I can pass on colds from person to person, and I love it. So I look at their eyes, and they have such love, such joy of having someone just be with them. And then I get into the stretches, and I stretch, and then I do the dancing, and as soon as I put some rock and roll or some happy music, they're shaking, they're moving, and that's it. And God again has helped me realize that I don't have to be a professional instructor. I don't have to be perfect. Just give your love and just be open and let my love flow through you. And that's how I feel. Like every week I go there, I don't know what specific things I'm going to do or cover, but I just feel their love and their joy. And then what happened during that time was my friend, a very dear friend of mine, she's 84, she had a hip replacement, but it was not an easy recovery. So it's been almost 2 years that she's been stuck in nursing homes, between emergency and nursing homes, because her health has been so fragile. And so when many people were turning away from her because she was such a strong personality, very strong-willed, and a lot of the nurses were not giving her the care that she needed, I realized that God was giving me that strong love, that forgiveness, because whatever she would say out of anger or frustration, or she has a very strong voice, she's a singer, I know her from the choir at St. Paul's, and people would interpret that as her being nasty, but she was just loud, that was her nature. And so I realized that was His hand. He was carrying me through this to have the patience and the love to just care for her during this time. And then I kept being asked, like, how could you be with her if she's so nasty? And I just said, you know, God really wants us to help her. And when people were giving up on her because she ended up on a respirator, she had a heart attack, and her family was planning for a funeral, I didn't want to lose her, and I prayed so much, and God was merciful, and she had a lot of very dear friends that lived very far, unfortunately, and they were all sending prayer cards. I think I posted like maybe 200 cards on her wall, and she survived, and her journey hasn't been easy. And it makes me remember the time when I've been told by others, be careful what you pray for. And I've questioned, you know, God, you loved us so much that you returned Anne to life, but she's been alone. It's been a hard struggle. She doesn't have family around. She doesn't have friends around. And the very few of us that are around, we're tugged in so many different directions. And I'm like, God, I'm so sorry that I have not been there. But I do know that when we ask with love, I know he responded to our prayer. So I've been back to, you know, spending time with my friend and apologizing to her for not being around or available as I was before. But I'm, again, feeling that strong calling and just enjoying my time. But now I feel like every stage of my life, I keep questioning, God, now what? Okay, so I find myself very busy. Church of Presentation has so many beautiful events that I find myself signed up for everything. And so I feel like I'm here 7 days a week. And then I'm wondering, am I doing too much? Do I need to pull back? Every time that I'm in the car and I'm in silence, I feel such joy and I just cry of gratitude, of joy, of peace, of, it could be of something sad. And I realized yesterday with yesterday's session is I did not allow myself to grieve enough. Now I realize that God wants me to go through all these emotions. He wants me to learn and grow from them. So what I thought I was doing well of not becoming sad and bitter during my divorce, I was just brushing over those emotions. And now I find myself in the car just crying and realizing that I still have that deep hurt and that I still have a lot of healing to do. And so now God is really showing me, look how much I can do for you if you just spend time with me. And that's where I'm now. I'm enjoying that quiet time with him and find myself realizing that I should not be keeping myself busy helping when I need to help myself, when I need to reflect, I need to think, I need to enjoy, I need to learn. So I'm just very grateful now.
Grateful.
What about, and I have no idea, I haven't heard you share about this, but Father JC, I think I mentioned this on the phone, he had you down as dreams.
Yes. So much I want to share. In terms of the dreams that God has sent me, I don't remember when was the first dream that I had. Since I was very little, I've had some very scary dreams. I've always had nightmares with natural disasters. And I didn't understand why. They were very terrifying. And as I've gotten older, what I've come to realize is God was calling me closer to him, showing me things that could happen, things that would happen, but most importantly, not to worry about what's going on around me, but just stay close to him, believe in him. And that was actually drawing me closer to him, those dreams, those very vivid dreams. And during my divorce, there was some very clear dreams of God's blessing. And I didn't understand them, but I've gotten better at interpreting the dreams. My husband would argue, he would say, dreams are just, you know, memories or, you know, thoughts. But I truly put my faith in God, and I know, and I've asked him, please communicate with me. And if it's through dreams, please help me understand. And so with a difficult time, when I've made decisions, I've made bad decisions, and I haven't known where to turn, he would, through the dreams, use words that I've never heard before. And I would find myself researching it. And of course, when God speaks to us, if we take the time to think about it, it's so clear, it becomes so clear. So when he used those words and I researched it, I knew exactly what he was trying to tell me, but I had never heard those words. So it made me laugh in the sense that I'm like, God, how could I question that you're so smart? You know, I know you have a big heart. I know you love us. Your love is unconditional, but you're a master of everything. I'm like, wow, you're teaching me vocabulary. It's like, I've never heard these words. And I was just in awe of how he would teach me through a dream about joy. And he gave me other words that meant joy and how to reach that point of joy. And then I did a retreat. I think it was a centering prayer retreat. That word, I picked out a butterfly, and the word that I got was joy. So he was speaking to me through the dreams, through music, through books, through witness talks. I look for him everywhere. My heart is open to him. So that was one dream of when I was sad. But another dream was when I had a bad friendship, and I was questioning what to do. And in the dream, I heard a male voice very clearly telling me to drop, but he used the word white peach, and I don't know if anyone's heard that word before, but I've never heard that word. When I looked it up, it was so clear of what he wanted me to do. But during that dream, I was showered with warm water. And I've asked people what that means, and from what I was told, that God was blessing me with the Holy Spirit. So it felt so real. And I realized that when it's something that he wants us to know and learn, he will repeat it many times through different avenues. So if I didn't get it from the dream and I didn't listen to what his request was, I made sure I saw it in different areas. So it's been such a beautiful journey. And I'm always enjoying whenever I dream something. I always look forward to trying to remember it. And I do keep a dream journal. And I do keep track of every prayer that I've made and every prayer that God has answered, because I want to make sure I don't forget the things he's done. Because when difficult times come, I know I want to look back and remind myself that he's always with us. And I never want to question that.
Before I started the tape, you were saying that you had not understood that there was a calling from, and that you have a new understanding about calling from now. Could you just describe that a little bit more?
Well, I thought that my mission in life was to be a wife, was to be a business partner, was to just focus on my family. And when I prayed for peace for many years, I had prayed for peace. I realized that the peace came, but not in the way I expected. It came in the way of a divorce. And after the divorce, I realized I had all this time on my hands. While the kids were at school, I said, what can I do now? And I realized that God wanted me to focus on the adult generation. I won't call them elderly, but God wanted me to spread his love, his hope, his joy to as many people that I can touch. I would not have been able to do that if I was married and still a business partner. I was traveling constantly. I was focused so much on helping the family business grow for my children's benefit, and not realizing that I was sacrificing my family life, and that I was not really balancing well. My energy was completely on growing the business. And I enjoyed that aspect of it. And I can't believe now that I don't miss it. I would never want to go back to that type of environment. I would definitely prefer doing something after my kids go to school. I would prefer doing something that's either voluntary or working somewhere that is helping, but not so much in the corporate world. So it's amazing that drastic change was not what I asked for, but peace came out of that. And I was able to focus now on something deeper, which is really enjoying God's love and spreading that.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Mm-hmm. That really said it. Is there anything else that you feel like, oh, I wish I had said, blah, blah, blah? And not that I'm looking for anything more.
Yeah.
I think you've done really well.
Thank you.
But I just want to give you an opportunity in case there's something else.
Well, yes. I think right now my question is, God, do I stay still now? Or is there something that you wish me to do above and beyond of what I'm doing now? And I find myself struggling that I really am doing something big, which is focusing on my beautiful boys and my mom, enjoying her. She's 77, and I don't take them for granted. I love my family, and I pray that God gives me the health and the strength to be with them and take care of them. I lost my train of thought. I asked the question of, do I go back to work or do I spend this time with my children? And I already worked. I already did that. And my children suffered when I wasn't home. And even though they're teenagers now and they act as if they don't need me, I know when I'm not home, they say, where's mom? And my mom is constantly reminding me, you think you're not loved. You think you're taken for granted. But they need you so much, now more than ever. As teenagers, they're going through a lot of challenges. I hear a lot of difficult things, a lot of scary things at school. Children being depressed, children committing suicide, children trying drugs. And I pray for all teenagers, especially my children. One of them is very good at sharing, and I pretty much know if he's happy or sad. My other one, I have no idea how he's feeling. And so I pray a lot, and I realize that I have to trust that the most important thing that I can do as a mother is pray and trust in God, because I can't be policing them everywhere. I can't be everywhere. And so instead of worrying to death, I've learned to just find peace in turning it over to God.
Beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful.
Yeah, beautiful, Allie. Thank you.
Nice job, honey.
Thank you.
Nice job.
I didn't cry.